What's up, Kanyo kids? We are now adding US to the list of countries that are accepting fully vaccinated travelers, including tourists. For the last 2 years, certain countries have been banned from the US, but people coming from all these countries that have been previously banned are now allowed to enter the US as long as they're fully vaccinated. Starting November 8th, the US will be accepting all travelers as long as they're fully vaccinated, even tourists. Individuals can only be considered fully vaccinated if they have received either the full series or a combination of approved brands for COVID-19 vaccine. Some of these brands are Pfizer, Moderna, J&J, AstraZeneca, Covishield, Sinovac, Sinopharm. US citizens, permanent residents, immigrants are allowed to enter the US. Added to this list are fully vaccinated foreign nationals. Of course, there are exceptions to the rule. Minors or anyone below 18 years of age, people who are medically unable to receive the vaccine, people who are part of a clinical trial, foreign nationals who come from countries with a limited supply of the vaccine, military members, their spouse, and children, diplomats, people exempted by the CDC for humanitarian reasons, airline and sea crew members. There is a but. Once you do enter the US, and if you are staying in the US for at least 60 days, you need to agree to take the vaccine in the US, which I presume is free. We'll cover more of this later. Here are the things that are required for everyone, regardless of vaccination status. Number one, negative pre-entry COVID-19 test. So the US accepts both PCR and antigen tests. For fully vaccinated travelers, the pre-entry test needs to be taken within 3 days of the departure date. For people who are not fully vaccinated, the pre-entry test needs to be taken within 24 hours of the departure date. Number two, proof of vaccination. So this can come in the form of a certificate with a QR code, printouts of a COVID-19 vaccination record or certificate issued by the national or subnational government, a digital photo of your vaccination card or record. Point is, all of these have to be from an official source. And just to be safe, if you do have a physical copy of your vaccine record, bring it with you when you fly out. Now, what if you have recovered from COVID-19 and can't take the vaccination just yet? Then you need to prove that you have recovered from COVID-19. Number three, you need to schedule an arrival COVID-19 test. This needs to be done within 3 to 5 days after you arrive in the US. The arrival test is optional but recommended for fully vaccinated travels and is mandatory for everyone else, regardless of the reason of your travel. Number four, proof of arrangement for self-quarantine or self-isolation. So if you have plans to do the quarantine at home, you just need to prove it. Like maybe, I'm not really sure how you're going to prove that one. If you're planning to book your quarantine at a hotel, then you just need to show this booking. Self-isolation is optional for fully vaccinated travelers and people who have recovered from COVID-19 in the last 90 days, but it is required for people who have not been fully vaccinated. Number five, if you are planning to stay in the US and are not fully vaccinated, but are medically allowed to be vaccinated, then you must agree to take the full series of the vaccine while you are in the US. But don't worry, it's free. Finally, and I think this is pretty obvious, you need to wear a face mask throughout your entire travel, not just during the flight. Next, here are the list of forms that you need to fill out prior to your departure, and you can find the links to these forms in the description below. Number one, the attestation form to the CDC. Number 2, the U.S. Traveler Health Declaration Form. Number 3, state-specific travel forms like in Los Angeles and Massachusetts. Number 4, the Philippine Bureau of Immigration Declaration Form. And for sea crew members only, you'll need the following items. Just like the U.S., Canada has also relaxed its rules, but 2 months earlier. If you want to know more about it, you can watch this video. I've also done a video for the Philippines in case you're coming to the Philippines. But unlike Canada and the U.S., the Philippines' COVID-19 travel rules are slightly stricter, and there is still some quarantine and isolation and testing involved, depending on your vaccination status. Anyway, I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to smash that like button. And if you want to know more about these COVID-19 travel updates, you can hit that bell icon to stay notified of any new content. Thanks for watching.